Hi, my name is Jason Hochfelder, and I'm an orthopedic surgeon with Hudson Valley Bone and Joint Surgeons. I specialize in hip and knee replacements. Today, I want to talk to you a little bit about the differences between partial and total knee replacements. First off, it's important to understand the anatomy of the knee. In our knees, we have three compartments. We have the medial compartment, which is the inside part of the knee, the lateral compartment, which is the outside part of the knee, and the patellofemoral compartment, which is the part underneath your kneecap. When the cartilage, which is the white shiny stuff on the end of the bone, when that starts to wear away, that's considered arthritis. When it's only in one compartment, that's mild disease, and when it's considered in all three compartments, it's more severe. So when it's only in one compartment, you might want to consider a partial knee replacement. What that does is it only replaces the cartilage in that area of the knee. A total knee replacement replaces the cartilage in all areas of the knee. So just to give you an example, this knee has two partial knee replacements in it. It has a partial knee replacement on the inside, where the inside part of the knee has been replaced, and it also has a partial knee replacement in the patellofemoral compartment underneath the kneecap. This can either be done together or individually, one at a time. And you can see on the lateral side, or the outside part of the knee, this part has been untouched, and two ligaments, the anterior cruciate and the posterior cruciate ligaments, have been untouched as well. The advantages of this are that it's a smaller surgery, it's a slightly faster recovery than compared to a total knee replacement, and that it leaves a lot of the natural part of the knee still involved, and it will actually give you a little bit more of a natural feel. When all three areas are involved in the knee, we would generally recommend a total knee replacement, which, as you can see here, will actually resurface both the medial, lateral, and underneath the kneecap as well. The advantages of this are that if you have a partial knee replacement, you are leaving areas of the knee unsurfaced. And over time, if those areas of the knee wear away, then you may need to have another surgery to replace those areas. If you have a total knee replacement, you're replacing all the knee, and in which case, although the surgery is slightly bigger, and that there's slightly longer recovery, you have a much less chance of needing to have another operation in the rest of your life. So just to summarize a little bit, a partial knee replacement only replaces one, or even sometimes, as you can see from the model, two areas of the knee, and has a slightly faster recovery, a slightly smaller surgery, and leaves you with a slightly more natural feeling in your knee. However, the downside is that it leaves one area of the knee unsurfaced or unresurfaced, and you may need to have another surgery if that area becomes arthritic or more involved. With a total knee replacement, although it's a little bit bigger of a surgery, it does resurface the whole knee and means that there's no risk of arthritis developing anywhere else, and that there's much lower chance of needing a secondary operation in the future. So that's the difference between a partial and total knee, and hopefully you found this educational.